back end of nowhere by the looks of it.
By turning your guns on the elite squad, you blew your cover, ruined the operation, and risked the life of a valuable agent. It is fortunate that she has been able to cover her tracks, at least for now.
Look, you got the intel you wanted, and I got something extra for you. I rescued a traitor who will testify to the fact that G&B have been illicitly buying Viridium mining drills. I'm positive that if you were looking for incriminating activities, you have it in spades.
Even though you didn't stick to the playbook, I must admit you are correct in that assumption. The Federal Council have enough to indict Blakemore. It is now more a matter of raising the political will to do so. Don't go far, Mr. Roslin. I may need you again. You will have to repay me for this botched operation somehow.
I put my neck on the line for you.
And your service will be noted for later consideration. Goodbye.
What a rude woman.
She let you live. She must have a soft spot for you.
All right, let's get back to base and give them an update.
Thank you.
comes?
Your guest has arrived.
Tarina's there already?
And an angry shouty man. There's about to be a shootout on our doorstep if you don't get back here soon.
I don't like the sound of this.
Looks like we got a bit of a situation on our hands here, buddy. New arrivals not getting along at all.
Maddox, Tarine, stand down.
I came here in trust, Adam. I did not expect such hostility.
Oh, typical Lizard. Always blaming the other side.
Cool it, Maddox.
Cool it? You know what a runaround I've had to take? I showed up here first time and there was a damn fleet cruiser parked outside. So I took the long way around, came back, only to find the damn Okar at the door.
Maddox, Tareen is an ally. I explicitly invited him here.
This does not sit well with me at all. Do I need to remind you that this is my base you're squatting?
Things have changed, Maddox. Do you want help or not? Let's discuss this like civilized beings.
Civilized beings, he says. Well, at least I don't shed my skin every few months like a damn iguana.
What an intolerable and despicable individual.
Maddox, Tareen, I'm gonna need you both to be quiet for a little bit.
So, how is your League of Nations coming along, Adam?
Yeah, Delia, I get it. Believe me, there is a purpose to all of this.
Adam, my friend, I did not come all the way to Ceto to be insulted by a raving speciesist.
I know, Tareen, and I apologize for that.
I hate to have to say it, Adam, but this mix might not work.
I see that, Ben. It's a short-term arrangement.
Hey! The vending machine in the canteen only dispenses two types of ice cream!
Okay, Alec, that is the least of my problems right now. Please, everyone, just listen up for a minute. I brought Maddox here because there's a job I was going to help him with, which might benefit us all. But first, we need to track down Maddox's other partner for the full details of where we need to go.
Yeah, it's true. I do need assistance, but I wasn't exactly intending to take on a whole damn crew.
They come with me, Maddox. Either you accept that or you're on your own. So, what comes next?
Old Eduardo has the rest of the map. Or, more to the point, he is the map. We left him on an asteroid in the Kaiit Nebula. We dropped old Eduardo out there as part of the arrangement so the fleet couldn't find him. He should be right where we left him.
Damn, Maddox. If this is how you treat your comrades...
It's what he wanted. We all need a little R&R from time to time.
Okay, so, let's get going.
Nuh-uh. I still gotta fix the freighter to make it operable after the blast it received. Ooh, maybe your half-robot pal can help me with that.
My name is Ben. Sure, I can help you.
Of course you can, Taco Bot. Adam, you gotta locate Eduardo alone. Just ping me when you get there and before you make contact with him so he doesn't get spooked by a new face.
What the hell, Maddox?
Just get it done, soldier. We don't have any more time to lose.
This asteroid I'm looking for.
Yeah, well, I didn't exactly write down the coordinates, did I? Thought we could be compromised that way. So I drew a picture, see? He should be somewhere on a rock near that, thing.
God damn it, really? Is this all you're giving me to go on? It's just a stick figure standing on a circle with some squiggles around it.
Kaiit Nebula, now! Sheer, you do whine a lot, don't you?
Incoming GNP General Broadcast. It announces that Outlaw forces have yet again gained strength in the Ceto and Union systems.
That's not good news.
I was under the impression that you liked a challenge.
Uh,
detecting G and B elite fighter craft heading this way.
That's just what I need.
There he is! The imposter and the Roslin look-alike. Get him!
You men, stand down!
That won't work on us again!
Start jerks. Okay, this is not your typical jump gate.
My sensors indicate that this is the gate to the Kaid Nebula. Certain markings bear a resemblance to architecture of the ancients, however recently modified.
Uh-huh. And what can you tell me about the Kaid Nebula?
It is renowned for its inhospitable nature, due mainly to the dangerous flora which inhabit it. There are also many species of fauna unique to the area which have yet to be entirely categorized.
You interfere without invitation. Prepare to be met.
What the... Hey. Turn down the volume, guys. What's up?
Surrender your vessel and shed yourself of your material garb in order to pass through the portal of redemption and gain eternal wisdom.
You gotta be kidding.
You must...
Hey, hold up. Who are you?
Thank you for the intervention, but I must hurry to save my father. They have him. He went through only a short time ago.
Whoa, wait, please. You are in no way equipped to take on those crazies. Why don't you tell me about your situation and what you know about these freaks?
She and B have abandoned the Kaid Nebula, and the Redeemers have taken complete control over it. They claim to have captured wardens and that they can commune with the ancients themselves. But I believe they may have become possessed by them.
The black eyes.
Exactly. And soon, unless I act fast, they will turn my father into one of them.
Why would your father have gone there in the first place?
He was lured there with the promise of being able to study a warden up close. Other scientists went before him.
Just hold on a minute while I think about this. I'll try to clear the gate for safe passage first. Appreciate your loyalty and all, but he would prefer it more if you remained safe.
I suppose he would, but time is so short.
What's your name?
I am Imogen. My father is Bernard.
Imogen, I'll track down your father. These cultists are seriously dangerous. If you stay put here, I'll be in contact shortly.
Thank you. Please be quick.
I'll do my best. captured a damn warden.
The beams appear to be draining the entity of its energy. Until now, it was not thought possible to harness the power of the ancients. What we are witnessing here, however, radically alters that assumption. I am picking up the life signal of the young lady's father from a nearby vessel.
Keep a trace on it, Hive.
Your priority is your search for Eduardo. The pursuit of the young lady's father is entirely optional.
Huh. One or the other will have to wait. One thing's clear. Looking at the drawing, Eduardo isn't here.
Thank you.
read me? I'm on your father's trail.
Oh, thank goodness! Is he okay?
I don't know yet. The Redeemers have taken him to another location. I really don't know why.
They need scientists to aid in unlocking the ancient secrets. I have a suspicion they dispose of all others that come into the system.
That's grim. But it would fit with their lunatic behavior.
This is marked as the Okrot Trading Station. It is unexpected to find it still in use without G&B employees to service.
Some diehards have decided to stick it out in this place. Looks like the lights are on. Let's drop in and find out what's going on.
Welcome, traveler. Nice to see another soul out here not gone black-eyed mad.
Yeah, about those black eyes. What? How?
Staring at ancient things too much.
What keeps you out here?
I like it. We keep to ourselves and those crazies know to leave us alone. So long as we don't interfere in each other's business, it's all good. Gotta look at the positive side, too. At least they keep the outlaws and those bigger G&B rats out of the nebula.
So, I guess they can be preferable to some.
Anyway, it's a hard grind making a cut out here, so there's not too much time for chit-chatting. We can trade if you like, or you can be on your way.
Wait, I'm trying to locate an asteroid in this system. All I have is this drawing to go by.
Oh, jeebus! I've seen monkeys draw better. That ain't much to go on at all. Although, that rock the stick figure is standing on is shaped a little like something you'd find out by the Kosh orbit.
Well, at least that's some kind of lead. Thanks. And, good luck with your grinding.
See you around, maybe.
seemed like nice enough folk. I'll have to check back in on them sometime to make sure they're all right.
Your constant consideration for your fellow man only ever leads to more favors and more tasks. Posited.
for this.
I would recommend trying to stay on their good side.
More Okar on their way.
Engagement.
Thanks.
A shame they cannot hear my compliment.
But this sure looks like a rock near some squiggly lines. Hive, run a scan.
I detect several abandoned camps of varying antiquity, but no humanoid life signs.
Hey, Maddox, you read me?
What is it?
Are you sure Eduardo would have survived out here on his own?
You questioning a Fleet Marine's ability to weather any environment, son? If he left camp, he had a good reason. He's out there. Just track him.
All right, let's see if we can find out what happened to him. These skeletons sure are impressive. Is there anything you can tell me about them, Hive?
They belong to a species named Cetacea orthoriensis, commonly referred to as leviathans. They are believed to be extinct. However, a handful of sightings have been reported around gas giants in the Ka'it Nebula. These sightings have been discredited due to the unreliable veracity of the claims and are regarded as folklore.
I guess the squiggles on Maddox's drawing are supposed to be the skeletons. I'm no art critic, but this needs a lot of imagination.
I am detecting an encrypted signal from within their subspace range. It could be from the person you are seeking, but we must locate its transmission point to read it properly.
Okay, subspace. And what do we need to do?
Simply locate and approach the signal origin. The entire data package for interpretation, the ship must be aligned for optimal reception.
Let's try it out.
I unlocked the data package. It contains only a single audio file. I will play it back to you.
Gazing on the stars has opened my mind to a new serenity. I have become one with them. Without a purpose, we are all but meaningless flakes in time and space.
Wow, okay. Well, if that is him, all those years sitting on this rock must have driven him ya-ya.
There are no signs of dead or decaying life in this vicinity either. He must have departed. There appears to be another similar signal nearby, although much weaker. Some of the local wildlife is causing electrical interference.
Let's take care of that and get to the bottom of this mystery.
I'm receiving a much stronger reading now.
Like he went star mad and took off wandering.
It calls me, but not on any wavelength I know. It is a strange calling. I must venture further to find its source. The only way I can reach it is by jumping over the Athorian fault.
Yep, star mad, no doubt. Now the question is, how far did he go?
His movements make little sense to me.
Yeah, it's a little weird. Let's just follow his trail and see what we pick up. Hey, Maddox. I think we got a lead on Eduardo. Seems like he went a little nuts and left on a walkabout.
He better have a damn good excuse for this. Let me know when you find him.
This subspace anyway, and how are signals seated in it?
Specific data can be written to and read from subspace, working as a limitless, non-physical and timeless data storage that exists everywhere and anytime in the universe.
Sounds plausible. anything yet, Hive?
I detect the faintest inkling of a signal.
Hey, Delia. How's the situation back on base?
Well, Maddox certainly is a handful. And he won't shut up about being awful rich soon. I'm considering using one of those tranquilizer darts on him.
Sounds like you have things under control then. So he seems determined to find something.
Another signal.
Good. I was starting to worry we'd lost the trail.
Thank you.
That we aren't. I sure hope he didn't walk himself into a trap. What if it was one of these megafauna luring prey?
Impossible to conjecture until we reach the end of this path. Yet another signal.
I'm sensing, Hive, that you are as fascinated by this mystery as I am.
My curiosity nodes are indeed tickled.
Entrance to the cave. It looks like ordinary weapons won't work on them. There must be something around here that I can use to get rid of them.
Acid melts things, typically.
A natural solution.
It is a calculated risk, Although I believe my trajectory can bring me closer by way of Shabar Tower, if my velocity remains consistent and the gravitational pull taken into account.
This Eduardo must have an inhuman mind for astrophysics. If he calculated one wrong digit, he would be spinning endlessly in space.
Yeah, well, let's hope he was able to work it out accurately. Let's take a closer look at this Chabar Tower.
It is registering as an ancient structure. Nothing of Eduardo, nor a following message from him. Although I am experiencing a high level of interference from the adjacent structure.
That might be the problem. Let's go in and see if we can silence it. Object flowing with energy on one of the outer towers. Maybe it can be used for something. The lens needs to be directed at a certain point on the structure? That repaired a huge part of the structure. Why don't we try another one of those lenses now? Closing in.
You better pick up some speed, boy. You have no idea how time-sensitive this whole thing is. Your crewmates have caught wind about the job. Not sure if I was talking to my sleep or just drunk.
Okay.
Yeah, well, now they're asking too many questions, and I don't like it. I've waited too damn long, and I'm only getting older. Barely have enough time left to spend it all.
Look, I sympathize, Maddox. We've all been waiting a hell of a long time to get out of this hellhole of a DMZ. And if what you say about the job is true, there's enough wealth to spread around.
Payday is coming. Just get Eduardo.
Opening up. I detect a multitude of ancient entities being released. At the calculated rate of travel, they will spread throughout the entire cluster.
Oh, scrap. I just opened Pandora's box.
One of the wardens appears to be honing in on you.
I suppose I shouldn't expect gratitude for setting them free.
Eduardo's message.
Means to decipher the signal, despite the interference from the nearby ancient structure. It is an impressive object, although the distress signal is a more pressing issue. It emanates from the planetoids below. I am readjusting leap settings to reach there.
Hopefully the last stop.
I can confirm that Aether 1 is a planetoid with a breathable atmosphere. I detect a humanoid life form on the planetoid below.
Great, finally. Maddox, we reckon we tracked down Eduardo.
Ah, now that is good news. Took you long enough. The freighter's almost done, but I'll take the maintenance ship and come to you. You sit tight.
Why he came to a hell-forsaken place like this, I can't wait to hear. We're being observed. What the hell is that? What is it?
Not sure.
Eduardo?
Maddox, I was right. I knew it was you. You finally came back for me. Kala! Kala!
You never said your friend was an android.
What? You think I'd leave a human out here on a rock in the ass end of nowhere?
It's okay. These are friends. The humans I was telling you about.
You ever encountered an alien like this before?
Seen all sorts out here, but no, this is a new one to me.
Well, keep your sidearm at the ready. I don't want any nasty surprises.
Please allow me to introduce Kala, my friend.
Well, hello there, Kala. Nice trick there with the bird. And say, where are you from?
Ulan Thradorka.
Okay, I have no freaking idea where that is. Main thing is, you're not a damn Okar, are you?
What is an Okar, Nama?
Kala is of no alien species on file. Although it has been some time since I last linked, she has never even heard of the Okar, which is unusual considering the ongoing war.
Oh, yeah, about that, Eduardo. The Okar war ended 15 years back with a truce, but we still ain't seeing eye to eye. Oh, and Dax is dead too.
Oh, this I will need to process. I must admit, I was beginning to consider the chances of seeing you again as very slim.
Of course I was coming back for you, buddy. But, I didn't think you would get so antsy and just jump asteroid like that. Don't you have an inbuilt gaming routine to keep yourself occupied?
I was brought out of sleep mode by a local distress signal. The signal was, however, one I could not interpret and matched nothing in my databases. I simply had to decipher it.
Ha! It awoke the cryptographer in you.
Precisely. I had to jump several asteroids to triangulate the source of the signal.
I had been transmitting for help, Toka. I was here for a long time.
Glad to hear it, but you'll have to say your goodbyes, Eduardo. We don't have room for hitchhikers where we're headed.
But...
Well, Kala, it has been lovely meeting you. Whatever you are, but we're here just for my pal Eduardo, and we are in a bit of a hurry, so we'll leave you and be on our way.
I'm afraid you misunderstand, Maddox. Kala and I have become quite close in our time together.
Well, that's not my problem. Okay, enough chit-chat. Gather your things and let's get going, Eduardo. We got work to do.
Two of us or none.
I don't think so, little lady.
What the hell is wrong with you? You can't just leave her here.
You want to bring an unknown alien species onto the base? It could be diseased for all we know. It could compromise the whole operation.
I can assure you, she carries no dangerous...
She tried to kill us!
We were strangers with guns. Would you have done any different?
Damn it, Adam. How many more friendlies are you gonna drag into this? This is my score. I've waited too long for it to come around. You're only here because Dex is dead. I'm done sharing it.
I only need to return home.
We're not leaving her here to die, Maddox.
Your choice, your responsibility.
Kala, it's okay. Help you find your way home.
My ship is near, Toka, but it flies no more. Some of the things on my ship helps you with travel, and me find my way home.
Okay, Kala. The least we can do is check it out before we head back.
Oh, hey, what? More freaking delays? No way! We are going right back to the freighter!
I'm afraid I must insist, Maddox. This is where I need to ask something of you in return for my patience.
Jeez, all those years of solitude really gave you an attitude. Fair enough. Let's get the Blue Lady her things, but let's not take too long about it.
Maddox, you never fail to surprise me. You actually left Eduardo here on an asteroid, all by himself, all those years.
What's the matter with that? I wanted to bury him, but Dax wouldn't let me. Would at least have prevented him from flying off. In the end, we just left him sitting on a rock, happily looking at the starscape.
After my internal gaming protocols exhausted their entertainment value, I observed many strange sights and distant supernovae in the eternal skies.
Good for you, buddy.
Trust each other at all, did you?
Yeah.
Your craft, Kala? It must have been enormous. You really need to tell us more about wherever you're from.
Yes. My ship was made for both long voyages and combat.
I mean, it's also beyond repair by the looks of it. Some components seem active, and there is a power core of some sort.
We got company. I ran into some of these freaks when I entered the system. Ranting at me about taking my clothes off or some damn nonsense.
Yeah, they call themselves the Redeemers.
The heathens pollute our divine-given sky.
They can be nasty. Let's just take him out together.
Huh. Redeemers? More like reweeners, idiots.
My ship, Toka, destroyed. My people, gone.
I hate to say it, but I doubt we'll be able to salvage much, Kala.
No. Try inside the ship still.
May I be permitted to scan on varying frequencies?
Knock yourself out, but be quick about it.
Perhaps utilizing the drone will help.
What? There's an exploration drone on board?
This craft is equipped with drone replication capabilities. Although there is an unlimited supply, the bandwidth only allows us to dispatch one at a time.
You don't even know your own goddamn ship? Unbelievable.
Tell us anything more? What am I looking for?
I must find a way home.
Yeah, we got that part.
My ship is able to create rips to jump through space.
Now that is interesting. This sounds to me like something worth following up on.
Well, that's a shame, because time's up. I got a job to do, and so do you, Adam. Enough of this wild goose chase, and let's get back to business.
Your home exactly?
I lost that along with the others in the fight.
Who were you fighting?
Ishtok. Against the Greel.
No. Haven't heard of him. Or them, neither. Anyone else?
Will you just shut your pie holes and hurry up with whatever it is you're doing?
something.
This useful thing, Clico. But I need more things to find.
I can't see anything else.
Sheesh. Ladies and their damned things.
No, wait, I know that ship. That's the Flying Duchess. Marie? Marie DeVent? We traded before.
Oh, yeah. How's it going, bucko?
Good. More surprised to see you out here, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, well, I had been coming here on scavenging trips for yonks before those loons blocked the jump gate and started processing... But it seems someone took care of them for the time being. Say, that wouldn't have been you, would it?
I won't deny it. Marie, you wouldn't have perhaps taken some components from this alien wreck on your previous trips here?
Maybe I have. Tell you what, why don't you dock over here and tell me what's going on with you?
Okay. Maddox, I need you to hang tight for a little, all right?
I am getting real tired of this scrap, Adam.
So what's all this about?
We have a colleague whose ship this was. She needs some of the parts which are missing.
Well, that's hard to believe, Adam. That wreck, wherever it's from, is old as dirt. Which would make it open to common salvage law. And your friend, a fossil.
I'm sure you're mistaken. I mean, okay, it's of a very strange alien race we're not sure of just yet, but... Look, we just need these parts so we can be on our way.
I don't have much. I used to come here way back when the frontier first opened up, so I got some early pickings. Some charred blocks with the semblance of some kind of old alien design. Quite useless. Here, I kept one specimen. You can see what I mean. You can have that.
Thanks.
Don't mention it. The rest I sold where I could. An Okar bootlegger took some historic interest, so I sold one to him, and I peddled another piece to G&B like it were a magic bean. Suckers. I also saw some outlaws picking over the place who took off with a significant-looking piece. I can give you their general location.
Thanks, Marie. I appreciate the information.
Say nothing of it. You did me a good turn, I do you one back.
Okay, Kala, can you identify this object?
Yes, Clico. This is a good part. But there must be more.
You're saying that this thing works? It looks extremely antiquated.
Yes, it works. Together with the other pieces, that generates the energy.
Yeah. Well, I think there's really something to this. And I'm gonna track down the missing parts for Kala. Kala, I'd like you to return to base while I sort this out. Maddox, please bring Kala and Eduardo back to base. It won't take long.
More time wasting.
I said please, Maddox. Let's keep it civil.
This new diversion in search of completely unknown technology cannot be guaranteed to provide satisfactory results.
All the same, Hive, I'm gonna follow my gut on this one. just what I need.
Your unsteady docking procedure gave me some cause for concern.
Hi, Tarjack. Sorry, I just blacked out for a minute. Weird flashbacks. Kind of personal, I suppose.
You are experiencing hallucinations?
I don't know what they are. Something glitching with me. Strange dreams when I least expect them. I really hope they don't kick in when I need to fight.
Such dreams can be deeper insights. It is believed by the Okar that certain celestial bodies can trigger visions and signal calamities to come. In any event, I wasn't expecting another shipment of djinn. What brings you here? Or were you lost?
No, I'm on other business. Do you remember being sold an alien component, a charred block with alien symbols? Was pointed in your direction.
Mary DeVint sold me a trinket that fits that description some time ago.
That's the one. I need it.
I must say, I am a little perturbed by your entrance and your demands.
It's complicated, hard to explain, but it's also important right now.
You know, if I didn't know better, I'd say you've been touched by Eshahar. But I say too much. The bauble is yours. It has no discernible function. I have no idea why I kept it so long. Perhaps it was destined for this moment.
That's actually very reasonable. Thank you, Tarjack.
Be on your way. Just never say I didn't do you a good turn.
Only two more components left on the list for Kala's experimental tech.
Have you seen me die?
I would require time to process that question and formulate a suitable answer. It is quite complicated and possibly not something that you would be truly keen to know.
All right, then.
Looking for a certain item. I was hoping you could help me.
Let me see. Nope, we no longer have it. It already shipped out to Central Repository on Damaris Starport.
What's that?
Anything we have in stock that doesn't sell is taken into the repository until it's destroyed. Can't keep everything here.
Could you help me track it down?
I think I've already given you enough information. Can I see your G&B credentials?
Never mind. I'll ask on Damaris myself.
Thought to my question from earlier?
Certainly. I am perpetually processing on many levels, but my answer will not satisfy you. I am familiar with all of your iterations, since I was installed as the primary receiver of new clones. Many I have seen die, in almost every way imaginable. Some have abandoned me, and there are many others I have no information on, as I am unable to link with the Eterna Cloud.
Hi, I believe an item I'm looking for has recently arrived on the starport in the latest G&B shipment. Here are the details.
Well, the item in question is expected to arrive today, but you are a little too early.
All right, I'll try again later. Hey, Hive, what are the chances that the component Kala's looking for is on that freighter?
I see no other log of a G&B cargo freighter from Prescott to Damaris in the recent time window. In which case, this automated shipment must contain the item in question.
Well, if I was good, I'd just wait till it's docked and start negotiations. If I was good.
Only now you bring morality into your decision-making?
Hi, could it be that the item I'm looking for arrived with the freighter that just docked here?
Oh yeah, the item just came in and has already been scanned for inventory. It can be made available to you for a processing fee.
Okay, how much is that then?
20,000 credits.
What? That's a bit steep.
Look man, the processing fee is non-negotiable.
You have got to be kidding me. Astral Way robbery. I've been fleeced. Hope this is worth it.
I have already warned you about the high unlikelihood of a satisfactory outcome to this folly.
A satisfactory outcome to this folly? But shut up.
Great. Now we only need to find one last component for Kala's experimental tech.
to Stardust.
Reinforcements. enough of being killed.
is now exposed.
Thanks, Ive. I know how this works.
Station has jettisoned its entire inventory.
Let's take a look. Little look around for what we need. So, let me see. I have the component from Tarjak, the part from G&B, and the part the Outlaws took. That's the full shopping list.
A collection of charred relics. I wonder how the strange alien can possibly make anything from these.
Well, we're about to find out. Ha! Got what I was looking for. Took longer than I expected. Maddox will be furious.
I thought furious was Maddox's default mode.
Kala, I got everything. I'd now like you to show me what all this is about.
Once I put the pieces together, it can be used to create a rip that will let you jump through space and hopefully take me home.
Sounds promising. I only hope it works.
Will you two please finish your damn yibber-yabbing? Adam, I've waited long enough. We got a job to discuss. Now, on the bridge!
Okay, all right, Maddox.
So, you've all met Kala by now. Who will be staying with us until she finds her way home.
It is an acquaintance to meet your pleasure.
Almost.
Yes. Well, now we have Eduardo here. Maddox is able to give us an update on the job at hand.
Viridium! A veritable mountain of it. Just sitting in a comet and waiting for us to scoop it out of the sky. I've been waiting for this thing to come around for a long time. Finally, all the pieces have fallen into place. Eduardo, would you do the honors? There it is. Drink it in, revisiting us in the DMZ after 15 years. One freighter load would be enough to make rich men, women, and whatevers out of each of us. Only problem is that it's still a heck of a long way away, and might take some time to get there. Oh, hello. Our freaky little lady likes to play with maps.
There, there, look, and there.
Well, what do you know? Looks like our dearest new addition found us a shortcut already. I knew she'd be useful.
Considering she's not from this cluster, that's fairly impressive navigating.
I do not know these stars, but I quickly find my way around.
Interesting. Well, I'd like to propose we head out as soon as...
I'm afraid I must object. You cannot carry out this mission. You do not understand the importance of Eshahar.
Say, who, what now?
This comet cannot be interfered with. I ask you to allow me a moment to explain.
Now, hold on there, mister!
What is it, Tareen? What's the problem?
What you see is an opportunity. What I see is something sacred to the Okar. Eshahar is of spiritual importance.
Oh, here we go. Always the same. It's sacred to us, scrap from you damned Okar. I mean, I don't see the big problem with taking one little freighter load.
No, I implore you.
Okay. Okay, hold on, everybody. Tareen, you don't seem to understand what this payday would mean for us. The riches from this comet is the ticket home we've all been waiting for.
Eshahar is a holy comet. The Okar would not send a simple squadron to protect it. They would see its defacement as an act of war and send its entire fleet. Your actions are of bad portent, and the consequences could echo beyond anyone's control.
I hate to say it, after everything we've gone through, but... I think we need to take Tareen's warning seriously.
Whoa, now, I've waited too long for this to be held back by some Okar superstition.
But we don't want any reason to start a war with them either. I think I should at least investigate this. Maybe it's time to talk to Commissioner Hawk. I suspect she knows more about this than she's been letting on. Tareen, if you're right, this may be more explosive than any of us realize. What I saw in Vesna, the artifacts, the drilling equipment, it's all connected. Stay on the base until I get answers. The stakes are as high as I'm guessing. I don't want anybody jeopardizing things.
You want to reveal our whole damn plan to the fleet?
I didn't say that. I said I wanted to enlist her help. We might be teetering on the brink of a conflict that could wipe out the DMZ. Until I know what's happening, Maddox, stay away from the comet.
I can't believe you would have the nerve to ground me, Adam. You know what this job is worth. 15 damn years I've waited.
Even if there's the slightest possibility that Tarina's right, we can't take the chance of an all-out war in the DMZ.
What do I care about another damn war? That's my fortune out there. I've waited too long for it already.
Well, you wouldn't have gotten further than Avonrest without me. Consider that until I return. Ive, patch me through to Commissioner Hawk.
Oh, it's you. I gave you this private connection only for extreme emergencies.
This is important. We need to talk. It's about a comet.
Not on the comms, if you please. No telling how secure even fleet frequencies can be. I am closing in on the demarcation line with the DMZ. I'll send you my coords. Meet me there as soon as possible. Until then, keep channels free and speak to no one.
Damn, that's off my charts. I'll see what I can do. Over. I'll need to make it fast. I don't think we can hold down Maddox for too long. Kala, come in. This travel tech you had me pick up, does it really work?
Yes, Kliko. It joins two places by a connected rip.
Having inspected the technology for myself, I have determined that it operates by finding a matching resonance between two astrographic points. This facilitates a spatial bypass of the two locations to momentarily manifest. The mechanics, I am still endeavoring to computate.
A spatial bypass. Interesting. If true, this could get me to the Commissioner faster. How about we try this thing out?
If you're ready, let's begin.
Hey, Adam, are you busy?
Am I busy? You mean other than the epic ongoing drama somehow always pitched on the edge of war, everyone's lives at risk?
Yeah, other than that.
No. Not really, I guess.
Oh, good. Thank you. Really, thank you. Because I was wondering, not that I want to be any trouble, but if you happen to have some time...
What do you need, Alec?
It's my kids. They're on my mind.
Are they in trouble?
Usually, yeah, but nothing to worry about. Evic's a mechanic, and Eric's a pilot, and then there's Emic and Edic and Efic. Oh, and of course, Epic and Ezic, who have kids of their own now. Can you believe it? I'm a grandpa.
Somehow, yes.
And there's still all the others, too many to get into right now. But it's been so long since I've had any word from any of them. And if you were to ever, you know, be in the area...
Where are they?
With their various moms, mostly on Avonrest. But it's the ones out at Coalition HQ and Drake System that I'm more concerned about. You could reach it through the hidden wormhole in Union.
I don't know it. If you give me coords, I'll stop by and make sure they're all accounted for.
Okie dokie. Coords are sent over. I'd go myself, but the Coalition told me to only show my face again if the cluster's about to implode. Appreciate it, dude.
For you, Alec, I'd do anything. Radio you from the other side.
Are you really about to offer yourself up as a guinea pig for an untested technology? This is insanity.
Nothing ever gets accomplished by not taking chances, Hive.
You can tell when you can fly through by the sparks.
Sounds fancy. Let's do it.